إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة فخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله. We praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whoever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray, and whoever is led astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as you ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul and created from it its mate and scattered from them too many men and women. And fear Allah through him, demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the wounds that bore you. Indeed, Allah is the Raqib over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that he may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and his messenger achieves the greatest achievement. Amma ba'du. Certainly the most truthful speech is the book of Allah, and the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen, and every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah, and every bid'ah is a string, and every string is in the fire. We continue with dhikrullahi ta'ala, or the importance of the remembrance of Allah ta'ala. وعن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يذكر الله على كل أحيانه. أخرجه مسلم. عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to remember Allah all the time. And this is collected authentically by Imam Muslim. Here Aisha radiallahu anha, she teaches us that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to remember Allah all the time. And this is to be as every other aspect of worship is in the deen, to be in accordance with Allah's book and the sunnah of his Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not that we remember Allah upon ignorance or the way that has been invented in this deen without the authority of the kitab and the sunnah, but we remember Allah in accordance with his book and the sunnah of his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there's no group of people who know more about the remembrance of Allah than that which we learn from the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah ta'ala, he says, indeed you have the finest example for yourselves in the Messenger of Allah, for those who desire Allah in the last day and remember Allah often. The best way to remember Allah is the way that the Prophet of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, remembered Allah. We want to take a look at some of the hadith that have been authentically reported on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how he remembered Allah throughout the day. And we'll start with the beginning, inshallah ta'ala. عن حذيفة رضي الله عنه قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أخذ مضجعه من الليل وضع يده تحت خده ثم يقول اللهم باسمك أموت وأحيا. وفي رواية اللهم باسمك أحيا وأموت. وفي رواية باسمك اللهم أموت وأحيا. وإذا استيقظ قال الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور. أخرجه البخاري بهذه الروايات. حذيفة رضي الله عنه says that the messenger of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he used to go to sleep at night, he would place his hand under his cheek and then he would say, Allahumma bismika amutu ahya, O Allah, in your name I die and I live. Or as it says in other narrations, Allahumma bismika ahya wa amutu, O Allah, in your name I live and I die. Or in the other narration, bismika Allahumma amutu ahya, in your name, O Allah, I die and I live. And when he woke up, he would say, Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. Alhamdulillah, who has given us life after our death, and to him is the return. Meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he has allowed us to sleep, he is the one who gave us our life back, or woke us up with the time that we woke up, or as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam intends by his statement, and to him is the nushur, to Allah is the final return, where he will hold us accountable for what we did in this world. If it's good, then he will reward us, and if it's bad, then he will punish us. And all of these narrations have been authentically collected by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. عن آنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل الخلاء قال اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث أو الخبث والخبائث. متفق عليه. آنس رضي الله عنه said that the messenger of that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he entered the place to relieve himself, he would say, O Allah, indeed I seek refuge in you from al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith, or from al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. And the ulama, they say that what is meant by this is the male and the female shayateen, or the male and female devils. Or as some of the ulama explained the statement of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that it means we seek refuge in Allah from those things that are disliked, and from committing acts of disobedience. And Al-Hafiz ibn Hajar, he brings another narration of this hadith in Al-Fath al-Bari, and he says that it's authentic with the conditions of Imam Muslim in Al-Sahih. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Bismillah, a'udhu billah, min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. In the name of Allah, or Bismillah, and this shows that it is prescribed Islamically to say Bismillah, I seek refuge in Allah from al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. And this narration has also been authentically reported on the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. عن أبي سعيد رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا وضوء لمن لم يذكر اسم الله عليه لمن لم يذكر اسم الله عليه. أخرجه ابن ماجة وصححه كثير من العلماء لمجموع طرقه. أبو سعيد رضي الله عنه said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said there is no wudu for the one who does not mention Allah's name upon doing so. And this has been collected by Ibn Majah, and many of the ulama say that this hadith is authentically reported on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وعن عقبة بن عامر الجهني رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من أحد ما منكم من أحد يتوضأ فيبلغ أو فيسبغ الوضوء ثم يقول أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وزاد في رواية وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله إلا فتحت له أبواب الجنة الثمانية يدخل من أيها شاء. أخرجه مسلم بكلتا الروايتين هاتين. Uqba ibn Amir al-Juhani radiallahu anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said
there is no one from amongst you who makes a wudu, and then he does a good wudu, or he perfects his wudu, and then he says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And one of the narrations it adds, Wahdahu la sharika la. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Except that the 8 doors of Jannah are opened, and he can enter into whichever one he likes. This is collected by Imam Muslim and both of these narrations. We're acting as if, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, since we're here in the month of Al-Muharram, that we're waking up on this day of fasting. And after we've woken up and we've made our wudu, then we're going to get something to eat and follow the etiquette of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in remembering Allah as we eat the suhoor, as we see in the hadith of Umar ibn Abi Salama radiallahu anhu qala, kuntu ghulaman fi hajri rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fakanat yadi tatishu fi sahfa, faqala li rasulullahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya ghulam sammi Allah wa kul bi yaminika wa kul mimma yalika, fama zalat tilka tu'mati ba'du. Muttafaqun alayh. Umar ibn Abi Salama radiyallahu anhu, the son of the mother of the believers Umm Salama, he said radiyallahu anhuma, that I was a young man or a young boy with the messenger in the custody of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or under the care of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said to me, O you youth, or O you young boy, or my hand, when we were eating, my hand used to roam all over the plate. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to me, O little boy, say Bismillah and eat with your right hand, and eat that which is closest to you. And this became my etiquette of eating afterwards, and this hadith is collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. And here in this hadith we learn from the etiquette of eating our food that we say Bismillah, that we remember Allah with the statement Bismillah before we eat. And also in this hadith there are some other benefits for us that it's important for us to mention, especially since we have many of the students of Madrasatu Ahl al-Sunnah with us, and we see them playing in the masjid and they should be listening to the khutbah. It's upon us, the teachers, and us, the parents, to educate the children to the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether they are our children or we have the charge or the custody of them. As step-parents, it's also our responsibility to educate the children to the sunnah, as was the way of the Messenger here in this hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An Abi Umamata radiyallahu anhu anna an-nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana idha rafa'a ma'idatahu wa fi riwaya idha faragha min ta'amihi qala alhamdulillahi kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fih غير مكفي ولا مودع ولا مستغنى عنه ربنا. أخرجه البخاري. أبو أمامة رضي الله عنه, he said that the message that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the tablecloth was lifted, or as it says in the other narration, when he finished his food, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he would say الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه غير مكفي ولا مودع ولا مستغنى عنه ربنا. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would say Alhamdulillah, or to praise Allah, much good and blessed with blessed praises. He would say, Our Lord, we cannot reject your favor, and we won't leave it, and we cannot do without it. And this is collected authentically by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. وعن سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال من قال حين يسمع المؤذن أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله رضيت بالله ربا وبمحمد رسولا وبالإسلام دينا غفر له ذنبه. أخرجه مسلم. سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه, he said that he narrates on the authority of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he said, whoever says when he hears the muadhin, meaning when the muadhin has called the adhan, he says, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله, I am pleased with Allah as my Lord and with Muhammad as my messenger and with Islam as my deen, his sins will be forgiven. And this is collected by Imam Muslim. وعن جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال حين يسمع النداء اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آت محمدا الوسيلة والفضيلة وبعث مقاما محمودا الذي وعدت حلت له شفاعتي يوم القيامة. أخرجه البخاري. جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما, he said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, whoever says when he hears the adhan, O Allah, the Lord of this perfect call, referring to the adhan, and the salat is being established, give Muhammad al-wasila, give Muhammad that which he can use to get closer to Allah and favor him and give him a praiseworthy station. Whoever says this, then my shafa'a or the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be for him on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And this is collected by al-Bukhari, and this is some of what has been authentically reported on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as he begins his day remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the finest example for us in making the dhikrullah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله. الحمد لله, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, عن أنس بن مالك رضي عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال, يعني حين خرج من بيته, بسم الله توكلت على الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, يقال له كفيت ووقيت وتنحى عنه الشيطان. أخرجه أبو داود والترمذي وصححه الألباني. On the authority of Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه, he said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that whoever says, meaning whoever says this when he leaves his house, whoever says بسم الله توكلت على الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, in the name of Allah I rely on Allah, there is no power and might except Allah, it will be said to him that is sufficient, you will be protected or guarded, and the shaytan will stay away from him. And this is collected by Abu Dawood and At-Tirmidhi, and Albani said that this is authentically reported on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Here we see as the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came out of his house, he remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he came out into the dunya sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we see here that it's from the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that he keeps the shaytan away from those who remember him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is sufficient for us to remember the Messenger of Allah, this is sufficient for us to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the day, as was the way of the last Prophet and Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I'm advising myself and the believers to hold fast to the dhikrullah, to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all throughout our day. But in accordance to the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'm advising myself and you all to hold on to what's authentically reported on the authority of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to stay away from that which has not been authentically reported on the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah alayhi salatu wa sallam. Because what has been reported authentically on him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is sufficient for us. As we see an example of a hadith that may be commonly learned or said by some of the Muslims, but it has not been authentically reported on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the hadith of Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه قال كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا خرج من الخلاء قال الحمد لله الذي أذهب عني الأذى وعافاني. أخرجه ابن ماجة. وقال البوصيري هذا حديث ضعيف في سنده إسماعيل بن مسلم المكي وهو متفق على التضعيف. And this hadith, Anas ibn Malik says that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he left out of the place of relieving himself, he would say, Alhamdulillah alladhi adhhaba anni al-adha wa 'afani, that all praise is due to Allah for moving the harm from me and making me have a good well-being. Or as it said in this hadith, this is collected by Ibn Majah, but al-Busayri, he comments, as he says on this hadith, that this hadith is da'if, meaning not authentically reported on the authority of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said in the chain of narrators is Ismail ibn Muslim al-Makki, and all of the scholars of al-Jarh wa al-Ta'dil, they agree that he is da'if, or that his narrations are not acceptable. So here we see an example of the hadith that has not been authentically reported on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a manner of remembering Allah. And because of this, I advise myself and the believers to hold fast to the books that quote that which has been authentically reported on the authority of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that when we see the hadiths of al-Bukhari and Muslim, then we accept them as being sahih, as this is the case in general, walhamdulillah. And as far as the other hadith, like the hadiths of Abu Dawood and al-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah and al-Nasai and the other collectors of hadith, then it's important for us to hold fast to the people of knowledge until they give us a verdict on the authenticity of the hadith before we work with it. And until we know the authenticity of a hadith, then we do not work with it, but we work with that which we know has been authentically reported on the authority of the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, make us from amongst the Muslims who hold on to that which has been authentically reported on your Messenger and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, keep us away from holding on to that which has not been authentically reported on your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the hadith that are da'if and maudu'. Oh Allah, we ask you to make us from amongst those who keep our tongues wet with your remembrance. Oh Allah, help us to keep our tongues wet with the dhikrullah, with the remembrance of Allah. Oh Allah, let us see the importance of remembering you throughout the day, as was the way of your last Prophet and Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, make us understand the importance that the dhikrullah will safeguard us and keep the shaitan away from us. Oh Allah, we ask you to keep the shaitan away from us. Oh Allah, we ask you to keep the shaitan away from us and away from our children. Oh Allah, bless us to have dhikrullah and our children to have dhikrullah. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Our Lord, give us the good in this world and the good in the hereafter, and save us from the fire. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله.